Hello, this video gives you the solution to question bank on English poetry section. In question bank, there are total 6 extracts. In question paper, poetry is section 2, question 3. Part A is for 10 marks and part B, appreciation, is for 4 marks. Let's see extract 1 of question bank. This extract is given from Song of the Open Road by the poet Walt Whitman. Let's see the questions under this. Pick out the 2 lines which describe the phrase good fortune. So the lines are, healthy, free, the world before me. Strong and content, I travel the open road. A2. Still here, I carry my old delicious burdens. Give reason for this statement. So as per the poet, the stress of life journey is called burden by the poet and he is happy to carry it. The poet carries sweet memories of people along with the path of life that satisfies him, hence calls it delicious. A3. Name and explain figure of speech used in the following line. The long brown path before me leading wherever I choose. So here the figure of speech could be inversion. And the explanation to this is, because the words are not arranged in proper order. Another figure of speech can be figure of speech alliteration. The explanation to this is, sound of the letter L is repeated through words long and leading. We'll see A4. Express your own views regarding the following line. Song of the Open Road. This is personal response question. Song of the Open Road. From my point of view, this line urges us to be free from our routine life. One should take this open road to spot on the different opportunities that our life gives us. We should not limit ourselves with the boundaries of life. I think we should live a free life, living behind the worries and problems. A5. Compose 4 lines on journey of life by using the rhyming words. So we'll give the title Journey of Life and then compose those 4 lines. It is a path so difficult and tiring, it takes daunting labor, thus scaring. Eyeing the dreams to become someone, finally it builds me to a robust person. And part B, that is appreciation, is from the poem Money. This is written by William Davis. So let's see. Part B, appreciation. The poem Money is written by William Davis. It reflects poet status as both poor and rich man. The poet is inversely connecting money with happiness. The poem is simple and has narrative style. The rhyming scheme used in 5 stanzas is AABA, CADA, EFGF, HIJI, AKAK. The figure of speech used by poet are repetition, metaphor, exclamation, onomatopoeia, and inversion. The message that poet shares is that money is not required to be happy. In fact, money brings along fake people in one's life. In my opinion, happiness lies with genuine people. Though few, they must be true. So we now move on to extract 2 of question bank. The extract is on Indian Viewers by Sarojini Naidu. Let's see the questions. A1. Fill in the columns based on your understanding of the poem. So the table that we can fill up is time of the day, early in the morning, late in the evening, in the dead night. Type of garment, robes for a newborn child, marriage wheels of queen, dead men's funeral shroud. Color of garment, blue, purple and green and white. For whom? This would be for newborn child, queen and dead man. Moving to A2, complete the following web about what weavers compare the garments being woven by them. One is given to you, we have to fill up the 2. Robes of newborn child with blue wings of the wild halcyon. Next could be funeral shroud for the dead man like a feather and cloud. A3. Describe in your own words the steps or measures that you will take to solve the problems of the weavers. This is personal response question and the answer could be, at larger levels, these weavers should get some subsidy or discounts on yarn. Also subsidy on loan for equipments needed. At an individual level, we can support weavers by buying products from them. Handmade products can be given more value than factory-made products. A4. The rhyming scheme in the first stanza is AABB. Find rhyme schemes in the second and third stanzas and also write down rhyming pairs of words of the second and third stanza from the given extract. So the rhyming scheme of second stanza is CCDD, third stanza EEFF, and the rhyming pairs of words are second stanza night, bright, green, queen. For third stanza, still, chill, shroud, cloud. Moving to A5, compose four lines on importance of clothes. The shirt that I wear is made of cotton and the thread that rolls through its button. Necessary are clothes I used to think to witness gladly draped saris of silk. Part B is appreciation of the poem Song of the Open Road by Walt Whitman. Let's see the appreciation. Song of the Open Road is a travel poem written by Walt Whitman. This poem is on the urge of freedom from our routine life. One should take this road to spot on the opportunities that a person wants. This poem is written in free verse. The poem has used repetition, metaphor, alliteration, paradox, and inversion. He used metaphor to road, which actually means the way of life. The poet used words like afford, strong, content, healthy, free to describe the adventures of life. The message that poet shares is that we should not limit ourselves with the boundaries of life. In my opinion, we should live a free life, living behind the worries and problems. So, extract 3 from question bank is the Inchcape Rock. First question A1, complete the web. We have to write the merits of Abbot of Aberbrothock. So, the solution could be, it warns of dangers, sends signals to mariners and to give directions. A2, give reason. The Abbot of Aberbrothock placed a bell on the Inchcape Rock because during the tide the rock remains submerged and he wanted the ships to be safer. Another reason could be, he wanted to save the mariners from ship collisions breaking as the Inchcape bell gave them signals. A3, if you were Abbot of that era, what would you do to make the ship safe from crashing at Inchcape Rock? This is a personal response question, so the answer could be, if I were Abbot of that era to save the ship from crashing at the Inchcape Rock, I would have installed magnetic device that could give signal about the Inchcape Rock to the captain of the ship. Next answer could be, I would have installed manual light reflectors so mariners would avoid the Inchcape Rock. A4, complete the table. So the first example could be, the ship was as still as she could. Here, the figure of speech is personification and the explanation is, the ship is given human value. Next line, no stir in the air, no stir in the sea. Here, figure of speech used is repetition and the explanation is, the repetition of words no stir is there. A5, compose a short poem. We need to write the middle two lines. So we can start with no stir in the air, no stir in the sea, of the quiet and serene shore to see. The breeze, the waves and the sun, her keel was steady in the ocean. Moving to appreciation, part B. This poem is Father Returning Home. So let's see the appreciation. Father Returning Home is a poem written by Dilip Chitre. This poem is a sketch of the poet's father. The poet shows the routine, tedious life that a person goes through. A person remains disconnected from family and the world outside. This poem is written in free verse. The poet has used repetition, metaphor, alliteration, paradox, personification, and inversion. The message that poet shares is of isolation of a person from the world. In my opinion, this simple written poem is relevant even today. Many of us may see themselves sharing similar conditions in life. So here we complete extract 1st, 2nd and 3rd of question bank. Do also check extracts 4th, 5th and 6th of poetry section. Please do subscribe for this revision series and like, subscribe and share our video. This extract is from Have You Earned Your Tomorrow by Edgar Guest. Let's see the questions. First is A1, complete the following web. This is about one's good deeds. We can write, Give monetary help to needy, respect elders, help and care for old people, keep community clean and healthy. A2. You have earned one more tomorrow by the work you did today. Explain the meaning of these lines. This means that at the end of the day, we should feel happy that we made somebody else happy. Our heart should say that we made difference in someone's life. We should be able to hear out God telling us that we did good work and we have earned a new tomorrow. A3. How does your good deeds help others to rejoice? We are remembered by small kind acts and few loving words. We should always be doing good deeds to those in need. We should not be ignoring our friends, relatives, or be bitter towards society. Serving others without selfish interest would earn us a better tomorrow. A4. Identify and write the lines from the poem which express the following figure of speech and explain it. First is alliteration. This day is almost over and its toiling time is through. And then vanish in the throng. Deed you did. Next is interrogation. We can write, is anybody happier because you passed his way? Does anyone remember that you spoke to him today? Is there anyone to utter now a kindly word of you? A5. With the help of following words, compose 4 lines on. Few words are given. We can write, see happy faces with the things I share. Make a choice whether to hold or give. I silently feel they need a bit of care. Only things that are sought to live. We move on to B part, that is appreciation. This extract is from Indian Viewers by Sarojini Naidu. Let's see the appreciation. Indian Viewers is the poem written by Sarojini Naidu. The poem consists of 3 stanzas depicting 3 stages of life, birth, youth and death. Viewers view newborn baby garments in early morning, marriage veil in the evening and a dead man's shroud at midnight. The rhyme scheme used by poet is AABB, CCDD, EEFF. The poet has used simile, metaphor, repetition. The poet describes life cycle from birth to death by the threads woven by the weavers and the time at every stage of life. The style of writing used is simple and raises readers' curiosity. This extract is from the poem Father Returning Home by Dilip Chitre. Let's see. A1. Complete the given flowchart about father's activities at home. First is given, drinking weak tea, eating stale chapati. We can write, reading a book, goes into the toilet to contemplate. And last is given, listening to the static on the radio. A2. Find the lines to highlight the relation of children and father. So the lines could be, his sullen children have often refused to share jokes and secrets with him. Next, dreaming of his ancestors and grandchildren. A3. Would you like to celebrate Father's Day? If yes, how? If not, why? This is personal response question. So we can write, yes, I would like to celebrate Father's Day every year on 3rd Sunday of June. I would like to give him a surprise by arranging a small party with near relatives, arranging cake and food of his choice. We would light the diyas and play soft music. All his happiness will be to see and chat with his friends and dear ones. A4. Name the figure of speech in the following line and give one more example. Coming out, he trembles, sat the sink. So, the figure of speech here is alliteration. Sound of letter T is repeated in the lines by using the words trembles and the. Or you can write a repetition of the sound S by use of words sat and sing. Another example of alliteration we can give with the line man's estrangement from a man-made world. Sound of letter M is repeated in this line by use of word man's, man-made. Moving to A4. Read the following lines and add 2 poetic lines to rhyme with the line. First 2 lines are given. We can write the following. Dreaming about the world so deep, enjoying the pleasing music audio. Part B is appreciation from the poem The Inchcape Rock by Robert Southey. So the appreciation is, The Inchcape Rock by poet Robert Southey is based on the thought that bad things meet a bad end. The rhyming scheme used is AABB and figures of speech used are alliteration, repetition, inversion, metaphor, personification. The poet first described the beauty and finally Sir Ralph's bad deed. The Inchcape Rock is depicting selfless nature of Abbot helping the sailors and receiving all the blessings. Those who are wicked always tries to trap them. Here Sir Ralph was trapped in his own misdoings. The moral from this poem is, as you sow, so shall you reap. The moral is still relevant and is timeless. This poem is Money by William Davis. Let's see. A1. Complete the web. The theme is poor men's qualities. So we can write, street smart, helpful and caring, kind and compassionate, happy and content. A2. Complete the sentences. First is, the poet wanted to become poor because the poet knew that money cannot buy happiness and will not satisfy him. Second, the poet does not want to speak to his fake world because he wanted to speak to few honest true friends and not the money attracted fake ones. A3. Can we live without money? Write your views about this statement. This is personal response question. Money is required to buy food and all necessary items. One requires it to purchase luxury products, investments and medicines. But one should not be greedy as it may never bring peace to our life. We know that we cannot buy satisfaction and harmony. Money can't protect us from illness or natural disasters. We need good and true friends and helpful people around us to live happy and content life. A4. Complete the following table. So the stanzas are stanza 1. The rhyming scheme used is ABCB and the rhyming words are poor, door. For stanza 2, the rhyming scheme is ABCB and the rhyming words are blow, no. A5. Compose 4 lines on friendship. So here we can write, true friendship is so rare, builds on love and care. Friend is our valued treasure, things beyond we never measure. We come to appreciation, that's part B. This is the extract from the poem Have You Earned Your Tomorrow by Edgar Guest. So the appreciation that we can write is, Have You Earned Your Tomorrow by poet Edgar Guest is based on the thought that one should always be kind and helpful. We must make efforts towards society contribution. The rhyming scheme used is AABBCCAADDEEFFAE and figures of speech used are interrogative, alliteration, repetition, inversion, metaphor, personification. The poet first urges readers to go towards helping and sowing kind deeds to earn a tomorrow. In my opinion, those who are of helping nature deserves a better future. So friends, subscribe for the educational videos. Please do like and share. Thank you.